Pruning maximises grape quality and yield for the next growing season. But pruning wounds also expose vines to the risk of fungal infection, particularly from Australia's two major grapevine trunk diseases, Eutypa dieback and Botrysferia dieback. While both cause potentially ruinous dieback, symptoms of grapevine trunk diseases can be readily identified. Vines infected with Botrysferia dieback can display many different symptoms, but its signature characteristic, wedge-shaped cankers, is quickly revealed upon cross-sectioning of infected trunks and cordons. Eutypa dieback infections also produce wedge-shaped cankers and are distinguished by unique foliar symptoms, including stunting of shoots, small cup-shaped leaves with necrotic margins, shortening of internodes and yellowing of shoots and leaves. Both diseases are propagated by spores, which are produced from dead infected wood during rain periods. These spores, carried by wind and rain splash, are disseminated throughout the vineyard. When they land on fresh pruning and reworking wounds, infection can occur. But both diseases can be prevented and managed effectively by protecting wounds and using remedial surgery. Dead and infected wood is first removed from the vine and vineyard, after which an additional 10 centimetres of healthy tissue is removed to ensure the disease is eradicated from the vine. A protectant is then applied to the freshly cut wound. A new shoot is trained to replace missing cordons. However, prevention is better than cure. So, to minimise the risk of trunk disease, follow these three rules. 1. If possible, avoid pruning in the rain or within 36 hours of rainfall. Accurate rainfall forecasts are available online. 2. Minimise the size and number of pruning and reworking wounds. And 3. Protect the pruning wounds with a registered product.